Very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to Sports Tonight. This is the midweek edition of the show. It's time for us to thrill you with our package. And I want to tell you that if you stay with us for the next 50 minutes that we bring in this show to you, we'll really make it worth your while. My name is Toyin Ibitoye. Let me start off the show tonight by introducing to you my partner. He will do with me all through the show. Although as we go on, we'll be bringing in some very special guests with us. But let me introduce to you Onyewuchi Nwachukwu. He's on Sports Tonight this Wednesday. He's always here on Mondays and Wednesdays. Onyewuchi Nwachukwu is the news editor of Sporting Life, one of Nigeria's best-selling sports dailies. And we are always happy to have him with us, share from his wealth of knowledge on Sports Tonight. Onye, good to have you join us on Sports Tonight. A lot to talk about on the program tonight. And I'm sure you will be in the right mood to do justice to all of that. Later on the show, we'll be bringing in our guest. We have a very special guest in the house. Who will talk to us, of course, about Nigerian football, and who has also been involved in a lot of charity work, giving back to the society from what football has given him. He's with us on the program tonight. He'll be joining us as we go along. And we will also, of course, be taking you to England. The Football League Cup is on as we speak. Some games are going on as we speak. We will be updating you with the results of those games as we speak. Arsenal against Southampton, Manchester United against West Ham. Those are big games, and we'll be talking about all of those games on the program tonight. We'll also be filling you in with pre-season. The Gold Cup is now at the semi-final stage, and so we'll talk to you about it on the program tonight. We will also be taking you to England. Yemi Adebayo told us on the show yesterday that Gareth Southgate will be confirmed as England manager today. That was the scoop all across the media yesterday, and it's exactly that way. Gareth Southgate is confirmed now as the new manager of the Three Lions. All right, we wait to see how much success he's able to bring to the team and how for how long he will be staying on that job. Of course, we'll talk about the girls. We'll take it to Cameroon. We'll talk about the girls, the victory over South Africa yesterday, and of course preparation for Saturday's final. All right, let's start up the show tonight. The way we started it off yesterday, the football world is in the mourning period. We need to tell you that it was a sad day for football yesterday, and we are still in that mood, in that sober mood, in the mourning mood. Because of what happened to Chape Coense, the Brazilian team that lost players in a crash in Colombia a few days ago. Thousands of people in Chapeco in Brazil have held a vigil for the victims of the plane crash. Of course, that has taken the life of most of that city's football team. The fans walked from the city center to the stadium where they prayed and sang, held a service at the city's cathedral. The fans, of course, were dressed in the club's traditional green and white colors, and they sang the names of the players and shouted champions. Very emotional it was. Brazil have also announced 3 days of mourning is official in Brazil. The flag is flying at half-mast, and they are, as we speak, in very grieving mood, as you can see. You can see the players chanting the names of the players and shouting champions. You can see that's very emotional, what is happening right now in Brazil. And the opponents, that's the prayer, and of course, you know, it's what's going on right there is really, really emotional. The opponents of the team in the final of the Copa Sudamericana, that's Atlético Nacional, have asked that the tournament be awarded to the Brazilians in honor of the dead. That's the story, and it's an amazing stuff, really. because the stadium in Chapeco has 20,000 seat capacity. The seating capacity is 20,000, but guess what? That stadium was filled to overflowing, and you can imagine how many Brazilians, not just right there in Brazil, but outside of Brazil, all across the world, now want to identify with Chapecoense after the tragic loss. And Oye, let me bring you in here. We talked about this yesterday as well. Brazil, these are the pictures of the club just 6 days ago when they qualified for the final of the competition. And Oye, this is perhaps the last video of you see of the team together celebrating. Only if they knew how it will all end.
Yeah, I mean, their relatives, their friends, family members watching this video, obviously we get emotional. You know, we know that death is inevitable, but you know, dying in such a tragic manner, you know, is quite painful. And these players had a lot ahead of their career. They were looking up for towards the final game. Perhaps if they had won, they would have etched their name.
And the pictures at the airport, yes, when they were about boarding that ill-fated flight.
You know, so I think it's quite tragic. We can only join football fans in Brazil, all over the world, to mourn, you know, the tragic death of these players and the other members of the, you know, the passengers and crew members in that plane. You know, we don't want to see this kind of tragic occurrence. I think the last time in Africa, it was a tragedy of monumental proportion. Mm. You know, wiping out a generation of Zambian players, and you know, still like very fresh in the memories of those they left behind. If you have ever been to, you know, Zambia, sometimes when you visit the symbolic
off the coast of Gabon,
that was
where they went down.
You may not be able to hold back tears. Mm. You know, so I think we want to pray against such occurrences, and we wish that the family members, the football fans, you know, the owners of this football club,
the journalists, 21 of them,
will have, you know, the fortitude to bear this irreparable loss. And we must take some clue from the way the Brazilians, you know, have, you know, celebrated the lives of these players. Look at the long walk. Look at in the past 2-3 days. They have shown so much, you know, sympathy. Mm. They have done so much to eulogize what these players have done for the team they played for and what they stood for. You know, so for me, it's quite painful to him. But what can we do? We can't question God. And when this happens, we have to reflect on what these players have done for their team and what they stood for, and pray that their family members be able to withstand their absence.
Mm. All right, seeing those pictures once again will make your heart so heavy, particularly if you remember that was just less than a week ago, celebrating qualifying for the final, taking out the Argentine club Lorenzo in the semifinals, and they were looking forward with a lot of promise to the final. The final was supposed to be played today, but first leg today, but you know the story already. That's one game that will never take place. And some of those players you will never see again. And the goalkeeper who was rescued from the crash site, we are also told, has had one of his legs amputated from the injuries he sustained. And clearly, that means the end of his football dreams. All right, so it was a case of a crash of aspirations and dreams. And we hope that out of these ruins, something beautiful can come out, not just for Brazilian football, but for all of us who are members of the football family across the globe.